So yesterday I talked about a brief review of bisection method, Newton-Raphson method, Regulus-Falsi method, and secant method, right? So today I will describe bisection method in detail and with the help of some suitable examples. So what is bisection method? Let's try to understand. So what we will do in this method, that let us say it is the plot of some nonlinear equation, right? Means it is a y-axis and y is equal to fx, and fx is representing some sort of a nonlinear equation, and it is x-axis. And what do we do in this method? That we will choose two points. Points x naught and x one such that they enclose the solution, right? As I know from graphical method that this is the solution of the equation. This is the one possible solution, right? So if this is the solution, so that means I have to choose two points such that those two points must enclose this solution. So that means first point is this one, and say another point is this one. Say this point is x naught and this point is x1. Now the solution, this solution, I am interested to find out this solution, and this solution is lying in between, somewhere in between x naught and x1. So bisection means mid. So what I will do, corresponding to this point and corresponding to this point, this is the value of the function. It is fx naught, and corresponding to this, the value of the function is fx1 at which it is intersecting this given equation. The given polynomial. Now, if I take their midpoint, if they encloses the solution, then what is the midpoint will be somewhere here. This is the midpoint. This is the midpoint, and this point is nothing but this point is x naught plus x1 divided by 2. So let me call it as x2. Now, out of this x naught and x1, which point I will choose? Let us try to focus on that. So first of all, if these two given points encloses the solution, what is its meaning in mathematics, in the form of mathematics? If they encloses the solution, so what does it mean? The corresponding to, if I look at this particular graph, then corresponding to x naught, the value of f of x naught is negative. It is a negative value and it is a positive value, right? So f of x is less than 0, means its value is negative. And similarly for x1, f of x1 is equal to, its value will be positive. Then and only then it will enclose the solution. Means one function must be positive and another function must be negative for the second point. We have to choose two points in such a manner, such that the function will be positive for first one value and negative for second value. And if one is positive and another is negative, what does it mean? That means their product must be negative. Their product must be negative. It means we have to check f of x naught and f of x1 must be, their product must be negative. If it is negative, then I can say that they will enclose the solution. This is the only way to check it out, because we want to check. Now, Now I determined using these two a new point. Which point? It is x2, and this x2 is x0 plus x1 divided by 2, right? And this is the new point, and as seen from this figure, corresponding to this x2, its value will be negative. That means if I have calculated its value and checked its sign. And when I checked its sign for this figure, for this given figure, its value will be negative. Now, I will choose out of x0 and x1 the point for which f of x is positive, because it's negative for this point, so that means out of x0 and x1 it should be positive. So that means, as I know from this figure, that for x1, what does it mean? That means for x1, f of x1 is positive. So that means now I will choose two points which points x2 and x1, such that f of x2 and f of x1 must be, their product must be negative. So the now this is the new point. So that means I will choose these two points, and what I will do? I will take their middle. Means now x3 will be what? X3 kya aa jayega? X3 is x2 plus x1 upon 2, or you can call it x1 plus x2 by 2, one and same thing. So this is the new point. So this is the new point which I am getting. Simple. So it is x3, and x3 must be this one. Now x3 kya hai? X3 ke corresponding f of x3 kya aa jayega? Positive. So now I will choose x2 plus x3 divided by 2 as x4. So what is going on? I am slowly and steadily moving towards a point at which the value of the function will be 0. And this is the bisection method. So if we want to generalize it, I want to generalize this method. Aur mujhe rukna kahan tak? What is my stopping criteria? Different books mein alag alag stopping criteria ho sakta hai. Theek hai? Ki ya to f of x n jo tha wo 0 ke paas ho, ya less than ho, ya greater than ho, ya nearly equal to. To hum ye bol sakte hain, it must be less than 0.0001. ek criteria ye ho sakta hai. दूसरा का क्राइटेरिया ये हो सकता है x of f of x1 n minus 1 and it must be less than 0.000001. कुछ भी ले सकता हूं मैं ये पॉइंट जो है. इट्स अ स्टॉपिंग क्राइटेरिया, लेस देन इक्वल टू, इसके बराबर ऐसे लेस हो, ये स्टॉपिंग क्राइटेरिया है हमारा. प्रोडक्ट भी एक ही बात है, क्योंकि देखो यहाँ ये पॉइंट भी जीरो को कन्वर्ज कर रहा था, ये भी जीरो को कन्वर्ज कर रहा, तो इनका अगर मैं प्रोडक्ट लूँ तो ये धीरे धीरे अगेन इट विल बोथ विल कन्वर्ज. तो कुछ बुक्स में ये स्टॉपिंग क्राइटेरिया लिया जाता है इस तरह से, कुछ बुक्स में ये. यू कैन इवन टेक ए नंबर स्मॉलर देन दिस. ऐसा कुछ नहीं कि ये यही आपका क्राइटेरिया, बट यू कैन टेक इवन ए नंबर स्मॉलर देन दिस. सो दिस इज योर क्राइटेरिया. मीन्स इफ दिस इटरेशन इज रिपीटेड एन टाइम्स, and after n times you will be reaching at this point. Okay, so this is the stopping criteria, and this is a way that how we can describe this bisection method. And let me try to generalize it now. Xi and xi, sorry, let me choose two points. Xi minus 1 and xi. These are the two points. So xi plus 1 kya ho jayega? Xi minus 1 plus xi divided by 2. और इसके corresponding f of x i minus 1, f of x i, it must be equal, must be negative number. Their product must be negative. Then, choose two, these two points, find out their values. If it is negative, then next point is this one. And if f of x minus 1 into f of x I is positive, there is a possibility. If it is positive, then x I minus 1 and x I, they do not enclose the solution. Then you have to stop. Search for other numbers. Search for other starting point. यही होगा, नए points ढूंढने पड़ेंगे. But if it is negative, then go for it. Otherwise, if this is positive, then you have to stop. Otherwise, what you have to do? Otherwise, you have to go to here. If it is negative, then search for new point. Now, f of x I plus 1. कैलकुलेट किया, ठीक है, एंड सो ऑन, एंड देन व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू एक्स आई प्लस वन एंड एफ ऑफ एक्स आई और एफ ऑफ एक्स आई प्लस वन एंड एफ ऑफ एक्स आई माइनस वन. इनके साइन चेक करो, चेक देयर साइन. इनके साइन चेक करेंगे विच वन इज नेगेटिव, एंड वी हैव टू चूज आउट ऑफ दीज फॉर विच देयर प्रोडक्ट इज नेगेटिव. एंड सो एंड रिपीट द सेम स्टेप, राइट. सो दिस इज द इटरेशन फॉर्मूला. This iteration formula, which we are writing in terms of I, and I can have value 0, 1, 2, 3, and so, or I can have values 1, 2, 3. So, I ki jo values aayengi, wo 1, 2, 3, and so on, n ho sakti hai. And when program will stop, then stopping criteria is attained. Stopping criteria is means when this iteration will stop. This will stop when we have achieved the required stopping criteria. And what is the stopping criteria? That f of x I plus 1, it must be less than epsilon. And where epsilon is nothing but 0.0000001. Or it may be smaller than this. So this is the bisection method. Right? Let us do a problem which can be solved using a bisection method. question है that find the square root of a number, find the square root of a number sorry square root not square by using bisection method. So let us choose a number and let me call number as D. Let D is equal to 25.0. It is a number. And I want to find out its square root. Right. So let us consider x square minus t, because what I am choosing that x is the square root of d. D is a number, so that means x square minus d, let me call it as f of x, and it must be equal to 0. And I want to find out the square root of this d, and I have assumed that this d is a 25. So that means let d is equal to 25. Let d is equal to 25. So what is my equation? Equation is x minus 25, and it must be equal to 0. ये क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन बनेगी, ठीक है? सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई वांट टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स एट विच दिस इक्वेशन इज सेटिस्फाइड, ठीक है? बट जब मुझे सॉल्व करना है इसको बाइसेक्शन मेथड से, आई एम नॉट इक्वेटिंग इट इक्वल टू जीरो. व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल अज्यूम दैट लेट f of x is equal to what? It is x square minus 25. X square minus 25. So this is my problem, that it is x square minus 25. What I will do, I will choose two points, x naught and x1, such that f of x naught and f of x 1 must be less than 0. Means it should be negative. So let us assume that x naught is 2 and x 1 is equal to 7. So let us calculate. So x naught is 2, x1 is 7, and what is the value of f of x0? Minus, put here, kya aega? Minus 21. So it is 2 square minus 25, it is equal to minus 21, and similarly f of x1 is equal to 7 square minus 25, it is 24. इसके बाद क्या करेंगे? Their product is negative, so that means new point will be x2 is equal to 2 plus 7 by 2. कितना हो जाएगा? It is 4.5. Now calculate f of x2. Now calculate f of x2. What is the value of f of x2 now? Minus 4.75 negative आ रही है value. Its value will be negative. यही आएगी, ठीक है? अब एक काम करते हैं, अब f of x naught और f of x2 भी कैलकुलेट कर लेते हैं, f of x1 into f of x2 भी कैलकुलेट कर लेते हैं, ठीक है? अब देखो x नॉट और x2 करेंगे तो ये तो पॉजिटिव आ रहा है और ये आ रहा है नेगेटिव, तो विच पॉइंट आई विल चूज, x1 एंड x2, मैं कौन से पॉइंट चूज करूंगा? आई विल चूज x1 एंड x2 टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ व्हाट? टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ x3। तो x3 क्या आ जाएगा? x1 प्लस x2 डिवाइडेड बाय 2। सो इट इज व्हाट? x2 क्या था? 4.5 प्लस 7 डिवाइडेड बाय 2। देख लो क्या आता है। क्या आएगा? यू कैन यूज योर कैलकुलेटर। कितनी वैल्यू आएगी? 5.75 इज द वैल्यू विच वी आर गेटिंग, राइट? ओके, सो एक टेबल बना लेते हैं। सो इज इट विजिबल? ओके, सो यहां पे इटरेशन लिखते हैं एंड देन the value of and now I will write down x naught here and after x naught I will write down value of x1 here and then I will find x2 now and after x2 I will find out the value of f of x not x1 f of f of x not f of x1 and f of x2 and whenever it is needed you can stop your iteration, right? So let us write down the value of this. The value of this is, it is 0th iteration and x0 I have chosen as 2 and its value is 7 and their midpoint will be 4.5 and corresponding to this, what is the value of f of x naught? Because what is f of x? F of x is equal to x square minus 25. So I put its value here and what we are getting, it is minus 21 and here it is 24. One is 20 minus 21 and another is this one, and f of x2 is what? Minus 4.75. Now what will happen? It is negative. It is negative. And it is positive. So that means what will happen? This will remain as it is. X1 remain as it is. Means x1 we are not changing. What will happen? This x2 is replaced by x1. Means x2 is replaced by x0. Or sorry, x0 is replaced by x2. Because for this it is negative. So that means what I will do? I will put value here. X0 is 4.5. This value. This is replaced by, that's what I did here in this region. Clear? Okay. Now find out their values. because now the solution lies between these two points. It is the mid bay, and what is there? What is x2? Because x2 I am writing it as x0 x1 by 2. So what is its value? Its value will be 5.75. Its value will be 5.75. And put their values now. So corresponding to this, so this is 0th iteration, this is first iteration, this is 0th iteration, this is first iteration, and if I put its values here, what I am getting? F of x0, it comes out to minus 4.75. और इसकी वैल्यू कितनी आएगी? It is 24. And what it will be? What is this value? 8.0625. Means I put this here and try to solve it. Karo jara. Just try to do it. Means ये कैसे आ रहा है, ये चीज कैसे आ रही है, ये वाला पार्ट. ये वाला पार्ट आ रहा है यहाँ पे. आपने क्या किया, एफ ऑफ एक्स टू क्या था? 5.75 इट्स स्क्वायर माइनस 25. जस्ट ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट. इफ यू सॉल्व दिस यू विल गेट दिस वन, राइट? ये क्लियर हो गया. अब साइन चेक करते हैं दोबारा. अब एक्स टू जो था, एक्स टू क्या था? पॉजिटिव. तो मुझे इन दोनों में से कौन सा चूज करना पड़ेगा, एक्स नॉट और इसमें, जिसके लिए नेगेटिव था. तो नेगेटिव कहां था? ये नेगेटिव है. तो नेगेटिव किसके लिए था? इसके लिए. सो दैट मीन्स नाउ इट विल नॉट चेंज. 4.5 विल नॉट चेंज. व्हाट विल चेंज? एक्स वन इज रिप्लेस्ड बाई एक्स टू. एक्स वन इज रिप्लेस्ड बाई एक्स टू मीन्स एक्स वन इज रिप्लेस्ड बाई एक्स टू. This is second iteration. So now I will take their average now. I will take their average. So इनका sum क्या आ जाएगा? Sum means अब ये point क्या आएगा? What is this point? Sum divided by 2. So 4.5 plus 5.75 divided by 2. So देखो क्या आता है? 4.5 प्लस 5.75 डिवाइडेड बाय, लेट अस सी व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग. 5.125. अब कैलकुलेट कर लो, एफ ऑफ एक्स नॉट कैलकुलेट कर लो, ये वैल्यू पुट करो, फिर ये करो, फिर ये तीनों पॉइंट्स आ जाएंगे, ठीक है? सो इट इज 4.75 एज इट इज, एंड इट इज 8.0625. यही पॉइंट आ जाएगा यहां पे, एंड दिस विल चेंज नाउ. एंड व्हाट इट विल बी? 1.2656. एंड सो ऑन. यू कीप ऑन डूइंग ऑल दीज इटरेशंस एंड it is 4.5. in the next step you can do it, and it is 5.125, and it is 4.8125, and here you are getting 4.75, and here it is 1.2656, and here it is minus 1.8398, right? And then you go for next step. Similarly, you keep on repeating this step. and you can write down which is replaced by which one. So it is 4.5 and then 4.8125 and 5.125 and 4.9687 and minus 1.8398 and 1.2656 and minus 0.3120. So it is 4.8125 and 4.9687 will be here. It is 5.0468 and it is 5.0077 minus 0.3120. Just a minute. It is 4.9687, 5.125, and then 5.0468 and 5.12. Okay, it will not be there. Let me correct it. So it is 5.96 and 5.0468 minus 0. Let me remove it also because it will not be there. Yeah. So here it is. Minus 3120. Minus 3120. Minus 0.3120 and it is 1.2656 and then it is 1.2656, it is 0.4706 and so on. We keep on doing this. Here it is 4.9687 and here it is 5.0468. Okay. 0468 and 5.0077. Then it is minus 0.3120. 0.4706, it is 0.775. ये समझ तो आ रहा है ना? ठीक है, same step हम repeat करेंगे, and so on. It is 4.9687, it was done, and then 4.9687. 4.9687 and it is 5.0077 and 4.9882, it is minus 0.3120, at the 0.775, ये वैल्यू ठीक है 0.775 एंड इट्स वैल्यू विल बी माइनस 0.0117. सो व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन, ये फंक्शन की जो वैल्यू है वो धीरे धीरे जीरो के पास जाने लग गई और वही हमारी रिक्वायरमेंट थी, कहां हमने रुकना, दैट इज अवर चॉइस। सो इट इज 4.9687 इज अगेन, देन 4.9882 अगली वैल्यू ये आएगी, ठीक है, एंड देन 982, देन 5.0077, 4.9979, यू कैन टेक देयर एवरेज, देन -0.0117 and then 0.775 and -0.204, then next value will be 4.9979 and 5.0077 and it is 5.0077, no it's यहाँ कुछ मुझे गलत लग रहा है, इट विज समवेयर रॉन्ग, इनका मिड आएगा, ठीक है, यू कैन चेक इट आउट। इसी तरह से हम कब तक इस इन स्टेप्स को फॉलो करेंगे, जो हमारी डिजायर्ड एक्यूरेसी होगी तब तक, अभी तक कितने स्टेप हुए थे, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 एंड देन दिस इज 9th स्टेप। आप 3-4 स्टेप अगर और करो, मतलब 12-13 स्टेप तक अगर जाओ, तो ये कहीं ना कहीं यहाँ पे जो वैल्यू आएगी फंक्शन की, दैट इज नियरली इक्वल टू 0.0000 के आसपास, ये 2 या 3 डेसिमल प्लेसेस तक आप, या 2 डेसिमल प्लेसेस तक अगर जीरो आ जाते हैं, देन यू कैन स्टॉप, जब आपने पेपर में करना है, देन यू कैन स्टॉप एट द 2 डेसिमल प्लेसेस और द 3 डेसिमल, दिस इज ऑल अप टू यू, ठीक है। सो दिस इज ए वे दैट हाउ द सॉल्यूशन विल बी अप्रोच्ड। और देखो, अगर मैं इसको देखूं, यहाँ पे ये 2 पॉइंट्स मेरे पास आ रहे थे, एक्चुअल वैल्यू क्या थी, एक्चुअल आंसर क्या है, 5.0। तो यहाँ पे जो वैल्यू आ रही थी, यहाँ पे 9th इटरेशन में जो मेरे पास एक्स नॉट आ रहा था, वो क्या आ रहा था, 4.9979 और x1 की वैल्यू आ रही थी 5.0077। सी दीज टू रिजल्ट, दीज आर वेरी क्लोज टू दिस एक्चुअल वैल्यू, दैट मीन स्लोली एंड स्टेडीली व्हाट इज गोइंग ऑन, वी आर अप्रोचिंग द आंसर विच इज रिक्वायर्ड, ठीक है। सो ये है इटरेशन मेथड्स जो है, नेम्ड एज बाइसेक्शन मेथड टू फाइंड द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ ए नॉन लीनियर इक्वेशन, एंड दिस इज ऑल अबाउट इट। कन्वर्जेंसेस की बात है, कन्वर्जेंस को मैं बाद में डिस्कस करूंगा, आफ्टर डिस्कसिंग रेगुलर फालसी मेथड एंड अदर मेथड्स, राइट। सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर दिस मेथड।